Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. This is Deep Cuts Reactions, and my name's Greg. And you know, yesterday I was on a kind of a tear and talking about racism and everything because it's just gotten to be overwhelming here in the U.S. And it made me think of this Nancy Griffith song. And this was the first time I ever heard her. This was what introduced me to her. And I played this song, but it's been a couple of years ago, you know, so screw it. I just wanted to hear it. And the video is actually very cool. But anyway, this is it's a hard life wherever you go, and it's got some killer lyrics to it. So here we go, Nancy Griffith.
Backseat driver from America. They drive to the left on Falls Road, and the man at the wheel's name is Seamus. They pass a child on the corner, he knows, and Seamus says, "No, what chance is that kid got?" And I say from the back, "I don't know." He says there's barbed wire at all of these exits, and there ain't no place in Belfast for that kid to go. It's a hard life, it's a hard life, it's a very hard life, it's a hard life wherever you go. And if we poison our children with hatred, then the hard life is all that they'll know. And there ain't no place in Belfast for that kid to go. Cafeteria line in Chicago. The fat man in front of me, he's calling black people trash to his children, and he's the only trash here I see. And I'm thinking this man wears a white hood in the night when his children should sleep. But they'll slip to their windows and they'll see him, and they'll think that white hood's all they need. It's a hard life, it's a hard life, it's a very hard life, it's a hard life wherever you go. And if we poison our children with hatred, then the hard life is all that they'll know. And there ain't no place in Chicago for those kids to go. Martin Luther, and I believed, I believed, I believed. Now I am the backseat driver from America, and I am not at the wheel of control. And I am guilty, I am war, and I am the root of all evil, Lord, and I can't drive on the left side of the road. Cause it's a hard life, it's a hard life, it's a very poison our children with hatred, then the hard life is all that they'll know. And there ain't no place in this world for these kids to go. This is a hard life forever you go.
God, such a beautiful song, and I hadn't listened to it for a while, you know, and oh God, that whole verse about, you know, being a child of the 60s, it just makes me cry, you know. It resonates so well with me. Nancy's the same age that I am, you know, so lots of common experiences, you know. And yeah, I mean, we thought that we could overcome anything, that the world was going to change. And it did, you know, it did. But it seems like we've gone backwards, and it just changed a little bit. So much of the racism and hatred and all this shit just continues. And I don't know, all the imagery that she had there with the little kids, you know, you know, when you're little, you don't know any better. You don't know racism. You don't know any of that shit, you know. So it would be nice if people could hold to that. I mean, I remember when I was 10 years old, and my mom and I went down to New Orleans, you know, and of course my daddy's family's from New Orleans, and we have a real common French name. And, you know, like I say, I was just an innocent, you know, 10 years old, and, you know, I really had never seen racism here in Norman. It's college town, and the reason there was no racism or no overt racism was because there was what you call a sunset law, which meant that if you were black, you were out of town by sunset. You know, so consequently, I was never exposed to it, and my mother, you know, didn't tolerate that shit at all. So anyway, we're down in New Orleans, and we're in, I don't know, some store, looking around, drugstore, something like that, you know, and there's this black guy standing there, you know, and I get to talking to him, and he's a real nice guy, and come to find out, we had the same last name. And, you know, I'm talking to him, and then, you know, mom comes over, and I'm thinking, hey, you know, we could easily be related to this guy, you know, I mean, he's got the same last name, we're probably related, you know. And, as tolerant as she was, that was kind of putting it over the top there, you know, but I was a child, and children don't know that unless they're taught hatred and racism and all that stuff. I don't know if, I don't know how many people from Australia are going to watch this video. You know, I know some people do, and some of the references, you know, it may be difficult to understand, you know, but that whole thing about the white hood, you know, that's the Ku Klux Klan, which has kind of been revitalized a little bit, you know, or normalized. Certainly the attitudes have been normalized. It's atrocious and frightening. It seems like we've gone back, you know, 20 years in the past 4 years. So I don't know, you know, it's so bizarre, because when Obama was elected, these guys were saying, oh, well, see, that proves there's no racism left in America, you know, and if you say that somebody's racist, well, that means that you are, you know. It was just insane. And, you know, they're blaming all the racism on Obama, and it's like, no, it all came about because you guys just could not stand having a black man as president. It was just too much. So anyway, it's a subject I could talk for a long time on, so I won't, and I'll be back in a minute and play something else. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. We'll see y'all then. Bye-bye.